There's a hole in my heart that you'll always cover. You make me feel like I can feel again. You make me realize. Hey yo guys, how you all doing? Okay, so I'm gonna start by saying I'm gonna do the part two of the TFD. I don't know when I'm gonna do it, but I'm gonna do it. Someone said that when I write it, if I don't do that there. So I don't know. I'm not so psyched about it, but when I get psyched about it, I will do it. So for today, we're gonna do some bit of story time. I almost got robbed yesterday. I was with a friend of mine. Actually, it was Jesus Christ. It was just. I almost got robbed. I cannot believe it, but I almost got robbed. So this is what happened. Yeah, left the house, went to deliver some stuff. Yeah, for those that do not know, I have an online thingy. How should I call it? An online shop. I sell outfits. You can check it out at Laura's Closet. Yeah. So I was delivering some stuff yesterday. And then after delivering the stuff, I was like so hungry, so I was like, let me pass by at a friend's place, yeah, for lunch. And also because I wanted to chill out, and also because I literally live in the farthest part of Mtwapa, and I still think there's some stuff I wanted to do Huko Barabarani. So I just said I'm just gonna, you know, be around just in case. So I go to my friend's place, and before we actually cook, we actually decide that you know, it's not a bad idea if we actually go to the beach. Actually seems like a really cool thing to do. So we cook, we eat, wear our bikinis, and we're like, yeah, let's do this. We're going to the beach, take some photos, swim maybe. So there's this beach we wanted to go to. So we went to it, but then it's kind of a private beach because it's a museum and it's a beach at the same time, so it's kind of closed. So we went there and we were told that it's closed. So the other alternative we had was this other place that my mom actually told me like 2 days ago that some chicks got robbed. They had their phones taken from them. Yeah. So we weren't like so sure about going there. Like, it's not safe and all, but we were like, you know, let's just maybe, you know, maybe, maybe we're lucky enough and nothing's gonna happen. So this Buddha guy that takes us there actually tells us again, like, I hope if you guys are here to like take photos, I hope like you carried a camera or something, because lately people have been having their phones taken from them at this place, so it's not really that safe. So two red flags, we're like, okay, something is seriously up. So like, okay, let's just,
oh,
our bags were, hi, my brother kind of interrupted, but anyway. So the phones are still in the bag, so we decided we're just not gonna take the phones out unless we see like Kharada and Gani. So we get in the place, and then when we get there, it's just some couple of dudes with their phones there. We're like, is it like so weird? Everyone's actually on their phone. So we decide acha tu tuangalie, like, acha tu tuone how it is, or something.
Why do?
Ray, please, they cannot do this right now. Go play.
Okay.
Yeah, so where was I? Yeah, we say there's this other place that, okay, it's a big place, it's a beach, obviously it's a big place. We go look at another place, as in it's in the same beach, but it's a place in the same place, like you say kuna rocks and stuff, so we like, maybe we should like take pics here instead. So your side, it was like so silent, no one there. Like, so we had to shuka some rocks. Some two dudes were there like chilling. At first when we were going there, we thought like there's no one there. So when I shuka, I'm like, okay. So there's some guys here, so I don't know. Like, we're just being paranoid. Maybe we're just being paranoid the whole time because we just got there and like, I don't know. Everyone's acting weird and we're like, she doesn't add up at all. So we're like, I told her like, kuna wasiaka, so we can't like be here with our bikinis and our phones and all, we'll probably get uncomfortable or something. So tukashuka, went back to the other side. When on the other side, oh my god, what the fuck? When on the other side, there's this nigger that was constantly staring at us. Seriously staring at us. I don't want to make this story so boring, so I'm just going to cut up some parts. But this guy was dead ass staring at us. So we saw him staring, but then we were like, maybe he's just, you know. So he was staring at us. We were like, maybe we were just paranoid and like these guys are just doing their own shit, so they wouldn't even care. So we went back there and this dude legit followed us, stood, stared at us like for a long time, then gakatupata sasa, and we're like, too many red flags. This guy can just be staring at us and following us. He can just be staring at us and following us, as in, it's a red flag, definitely a red flag. So, there's this dude that was there when you tumipata wakwapo, the first time tumikuja, tumingia, there's some guys that were there. So this guy asked us, like, nah, mekuja kusui mama, told them we were just chilling and stuff, but this guy, there's some guy that keeps following us, and we don't know if we're being paranoid, ama. So he's like, maybe you're not being paranoid, you're just being cautious, because, like, you never know, yeah. So we actually decide, this dude is following us too many times, so let's just go back to the other place. Tukarudi yo side. Tukirudi akatupata tena. When he spotted, he signaled some guy, and all of a sudden, like, seven guys just come in, and we're like, oh my god, who are these people? Like, 2 minutes, like, we gotta leave this place. So we actually leave. When we leave, we just decide to walk instead of taking up with us, so we just walk. We walk for a couple of while. And then at some point, oh my god, we turn and legit, these two niggas are still following us. They are still following us. Like, they are still following us. You know, at some point I was thinking, maybe it's because I was carrying a big bag, so maybe it's like capturing attention and stuff. It's like capturing attention and stuff, so maybe it was the bag. But I'm not like so sure if it was the bag or not. Like, I do not know. But this guy was seriously following us. So we keep walking and then we just decide, you know what, let's just take a boda boda, because no, these are too many red flags, we just cannot do this. And we actually leave. Ciao. Okay. Four. Urudi re, kabla usiku ifike.
Damn, I just spoiled my video. But anyway, I hope I didn't talk too much and I hope you actually followed the flow of the story, because I was telling this to Hadin today and I was like, deadass, I do not understand what you're saying. But I hope you all understood what I was saying. I spared up, we almost got up yesterday. Too many red flags, not like, not being so paranoid or anything. Anyways, peace you guys, keep safe and all that. Yeah, my brother and my little cousin just, anyway, it's all good.